Hey everyone, welcome back to another Dr. Twisted's Toy Time. Well, this Saturday I was able to go out thrift store shopping. I stopped at Ross because I wanted to see if they got anything new, and all the stuff that they stocked last time was gone. I mean, it was practically empty. They had like the same old stuff that's been there forever. So I didn't get any footage of that because it was a waste of time. And then I went to, well, the other night we went to Target and I got a couple things. So I'll show those. And I got one package from eBay. And then I went to two thrift stores. I went to one called Thrift Haven, which I did some footage before. So I went back there, found a bunch of cool, like a couple bags that I'll open with you and a few other things. And then I went to another place called Red Racks, which their prices are ridiculous. They had some cool stuff there, but most of it was missing things, and then they were charging ridiculous prices. So I only picked up a couple things from there that were reasonable and some stuff that I wanted. So I went ahead and bought those. So let me get on. I will show the footage from Thrift Haven first, and that was a fun little, like I said, a fun little walkthrough, and I found a bunch of cool stuff, and then I'll do the walkthrough from Ross, and then I'll do the scores at the end. So until then, friends, peace.
Already got two of these, and this one's missing an arrow. Dino. Little bag of dinos. How to Train Your Dragon, missing a tail. Cool. Tanks and hover things, I guess. Missing everything. Cars. I like these things, but I already got like three of them, I think. Why not? Well, look at this little Hulk. It's crazy. For a quarter. Yes, please. I think these are those same knockoffs that I found the other week. And this guy, I've had him a few times. He used to sell pretty good. They want 75 cents. I'll leave him for the next guy because I'm not an eBay seller anymore. Bag full of cowboys and Indians. Nothing really for me there. It's Harold. Is that Thomas the Tank Engine or something? Now just to show you what I found already. I found this guy. Looks like he's missing the top of his head, but for a dollar, I'm not leaving him behind. I could customize something. Got a Furby for my daughter. But, this bag here has got a couple cool little toys in it. And this bag's got a couple little cool toys in it. show you the breakdown when I am at home. Some dolls. Is that like a... Interesting up here, not really. Iron Man mask. I still have this sword. I'm surprised that didn't sell. Saber. They got one of the big Imaginex dinos. I've already got this, but this is an awesome vehicle. I'm gonna have to get it just because. Nothing down there. It's a bunch of My Little Ponies. Oh, there's that dinosaur's arm. A little Imaginex bat cycle. Which is that? 50 cents. Alright. Bunch of little plushies. This side here, some 101 Dalmatians, kind of neat. I don't know if that's like a Play-Doh dinosaur or something. It's pretty neat. Still have this dinosaur squishy head. McDonald's toys. One of those Iron Man flyers. Groot. Pug fairy. Thing here. What is this thing? Weird. Cabbage Patch 35 piece floor puzzle. Don't know if it's complete or not, but I'll leave that for someone else. These are cool. Little Megatron and Bumblebee plushies. I dig those.
And now for the Red Racks walkthrough. Check it out. Peace.
I'm at another thrift store called Red Racks. Seeing what I can find. Curious George Lynch box. Here's old Batman. When does this come out? $6 for this guy, and he's missing a horn. This place is ridiculous. $5 for Pops. Send a warning. Adam looks tired. It's a fun piece. $10 for it.
All right, let's get started with the haul. First, I will show what I got from Thrift Haven, which I picked up 3 bags. I tore them open because it's always hard to open them with one hand, so I'm just going to dump the stuff out and we can go through it together. If it all will come out. Let's see what we got here. All right, first there's this little 10 coin, whatever that's from. Got this cool little Triceratops. Always ever-growing dinosaur collection. There's this crazy thing. My daughter might like this. She likes clowns. So that's one of the reasons I picked this up. She likes dogs and clowns, and it looks like a dog clown. There's some kind of telescope. Maybe an Imaginex toy or something. Not sure. Elmo! Can burn him. Here's some, looks like biker guy. It's like a rubbery dude. This looks like, is that Duke? Is this one of the Dollar Tree G.I. Joe figures or something? I never seen these here, if it is. So that's cool, because I've been wanting those. Here's some little dude with a shovel and a helmet. Or is that a paddle? It was supposed to be like a canoe or something. The life jacket. Not sure. Thought this was cool. Death JK. Not sure what it is. But thought it was neat looking. Here's a pistol. Kind of looks like a Star Wars gun. Not exactly sure, though. Some weird fish. Ladybug. I thought this was cool. This little wood block with food and stuff is on it. A little mouse. Not sure what it went to. Maybe one of those like wood block building sets. You had the little like dowels that you stick in here and it connects to other pieces. Not sure. And then there's this guy. Is he, having a brain fart on him? And is this the Last Action Hero, or is this the Captain Planet or something? His hand's obviously missing, but I can customize him somehow. Put a gun in his hand. There's the first bag. Now on to the second bag, which I basically got it for this guy. I thought he was neat looking. And I've got several of these ninjas. I like those. I actually got my daughter the Sonic of this not too long ago, so she'll like that. This is another reason I got it, is I like these little robots. And here's a little like dollar store military man. And a tattooed up Imaginex figure. So I got, probably doesn't go to him, but here's a, there you go. It's 2 bags, and this one is probably my favorite bag. It's all little skateboarders. You see, there's Skater Girl. This dude. This guy's doing a trick. There's another Skater Girl, and another Skater Girl. This guy's doing a handstand.
handstand guy. Skater, lots of skater girls. So there's 3, 4 so far. All right, 5. All right, 5 different characters. You got the guy doing the trick, the skater girl, this guy just pushing, this guy like he's just soaring down the road, and then this guy doing a handstand. I thought those were neat. I grew up skateboarding, so I still love the sport, and I love watching it. I just can't do it because my knees are bad, and my back is bad if I step on a skateboard. But there's the bags. Now let's get on to the other stuff. All right. I found this little dinosaur, and I brought him home. I thought he was cool. I think it's like Play-Doh or something. It has these things that you can make like little jewels or something with. Thought that was cool. I ended up getting this thing, so now I have like 4 of these, I believe. I just really like the look of this thing for some reason. And I ended up getting that silly looking Hulk. I just think he looks so goofy. And for $2, I couldn't leave Megatron behind. He's just adorable. I think he's from 2023, but still with tags and everything, I had to, couldn't leave him behind. And I got this, Protarian Warrior or whatever, Protarian Guard, however you pronounce it. It is missing the top round piece, so I'm probably just going to customize that with some soft air dry clay or something. Or customize it and put like a big gun cannon on it. Paint them up, do something with them. I just really like the look of that figure, so I couldn't leave him behind for $1. And then I ended up getting this vehicle. The belt's still there. The wings are still there. The function still works. The missiles are missing, but that's okay, because it's the same with my other one. I got my other one up there on the corner of that cabinet. I just really like the look of that vehicle. But there was the stuff I got at Thrift Haven. Now the stuff I got at Red Racks is right over here. I picked up this dinosaur. I thought I saw this on 80s Toy Rock with Burf. I thought he had a few of these. He said they were worth something, and I really like dinos. I just thought it was cool, so I picked it up. And then I really like the look of these. They wrote on them, which is dumb. $4, I figured. I'll save them and bring them home, because I like them. And then I ended up getting the Age of the Behemoth Brontosaurus 2-pack. I just really like the look of this. It's got a couple tears in the box and stuff, but I think it still displays well and just looks cool. I like the art in the background, how it's got the volcanoes and the very cool stuff. And then it's got the 10 awesome facts about the Brontosaurus on the back. If you want to read them, you can pause and check out those facts. But I just really like it. I don't know if it's vintage. I couldn't find a date on it. But it's probably newer. But for $4, I couldn't leave it behind. If anything, I'll just cut the heads off and do some customs or something. All right. Now at Target, I found this awesome little Transformers the Movie Exosuit Spike Witwicky.
Never would have thought we would have seen this figure, but I got him on clearance for, you know, $5. And I always thought that was fun. Always dreamed about having my own little mech suit when I was a kid, so that was, to me, I liked it. And then I ended up getting the Misfits Ultimate Fiend action figure. This thing is amazingly cool. Love that package art right there. He's all set up. Comes with the three heads. These two almost look identical, so I don't know what's... Looks like maybe one has painted pupils and the other one doesn't. And then this one is cool. And it comes with the two knives. The horror business. The gravestone. The candelabra. And the figure, sorry about the flash. And then the cool Misfits art on the back, or side. Misfits Ultimate Fiend action figure, Night of the Living Dead. Mommy, can I go out and kill? Man, what is up with my voice? Screaming too hard at the concert last night. There's Death Comes Ripping. Horror business and skulls. Misfits has always been one of my favorite bands, so I love picking up Misfit stuff. And what I got from eBay is this Ghost Rider. Made me mad though, because he sent this in a freaking envelope and it showed up all damaged. And I'm like, dude, you sent this in an envelope. And I kind of wanted to keep this in the package because the art was so awesome. And I had to open it because I looked in the hole and in the center of the box there's nothing. It's like the figure's on this side and the bike is all the way on this side. So when I looked in it, I got scared. I'm like, oh, did they steal the stuff out of the package? So I opened it up and no, the actual figure and the bikes were in there. So that's cool. So now I just had to open it, but it just pissed me off because the hole is right through the artwork. And the guy was kind of a dick. I'm like, can you just take a couple bucks off for, you know, the package getting destroyed? And he's like, I'll totally refund you, but you have to send it back. I'm like, dude, I already opened it. I don't want to send it back, but I don't want to pay full price if it box came all smashed in. But he was being a jerk, so I just kept it. I wanted this figure for a while anyway in my Target. I never seen it at my Target, so I'm happy to have him. I would have loved to have kept this one in the box because it's just the presentation of the box is just awesome. I might try to figure if I can tape the hole from the inside and see if I can fix it up so it doesn't look that bad and then display the box anyway and then display the figure, but just makes me sad that people send mint in box stuff in an envelope and think it's going to be cool. It's not, people. Send them in a box, protected. But there you go, friends. That was my two thrift store hauls. Man, my voice is cracking. I was definitely screaming a lot at that Galactic Empire concert. So my voice is not the best right now. But anyway, thanks for tuning in. And until next time, friends, peace.